I was born in Marlton, Arkansas, a small town about 50 miles west of Little Rock. I was about to be drafted, and so I decided I'd rather pick out my own service and have them draft me and put me in the Army. So I applied for the V-5 program, which was the Navy program, and became a pilot.
On February 15, 1944, American forces launched a major air raid on a powerfully defended Japanese airbase at Kavieng on the northern tip of New Ireland. Flying a rescue patrol in the area was 27-year-old Nathan Gordon at the controls of a PBY Catalina seaplane. With the battle raging around them, Gordon and his crew had to continually scan the 15-foot swells for signs of American pilots plucked violently from the sky by heavy Japanese anti-aircraft fire.
Shortly after we'd gotten together with the Army planes, I had a call from an Army plane somewhere, I don't know where they were, but he said he had a plane down and he'd give me the location of it, which he did. I flew over it and the plane had already sunk, it wasn't there. But there was a lot of oil in the water, a lot of dye mockery, and there was one large life raft, but I couldn't see anybody in it. So I took off as soon as I found that out. And barely got airborne again until a plane, and I think it was the same plane, says, if I have another plane down, I'll lead you to it. So we went into that one, and it was a life raft with three people in it. So we did the same procedure. The only problem being was that I had my power back as low as it would go, but that was enough where it would pull me through the water and they couldn't get the life raft in. So I finally asked them, what's wrong back there? They said, well, Nathan, you're going to have to cut your engine. So we can't pull the boat in. I said, oh my goodness, you don't like to do that because lots of times they don't start for many reasons. So anyway, I did. They got them in and there was three of them. Pretty bummed up, but not just real serious. So I took off then, and again, I hardly got airborne again to the same plane. Said, I've got another plane down for you. And it was quite a bit closer to the shore. It wasn't more than a mile. And we'd get a lot of feedback from shore out to where we were. It's difficult to get about lifeboats onto our plane in rough water, but they got them aboard. And, then we started to take off again. I started my port engine and it fired real good. And then I tried to start my right engine and I couldn't get it started. I fooled around with it for 2-3 minutes and still wouldn't start, so I thought the only thing I could do was just to let it rest for a minute. And then I tried again, we got it started. And we took off. And I thought that was all there were there.
With this plane taking a heavy pounding, Gordon headed back to base to deliver the wounded. But almost instantly, he received another call reporting a crew stranded a mere 600 yards offshore. With 9 rescued airmen aboard and 10 in his crew, he now risked losing all 19 lives in an additional rescue.
Of course, the decision was mine. I wasn't going to leave it up to the crew to make a decision what I was going to do. But I just couldn't leave them back there. That's what I'm about to. And I knew I had to go back and try.
Gordon's approach took him directly over the Japanese batteries at a perilous 300 feet, landing once more in dangerous swells and buffeted by enemy fire. He and his crew rescued 6 more survivors before finally returning to base.
Now, I never heard anything at all about it for several months. I continued to fly patrols and I didn't think about any award, to be frank about it. Because, you know, you're doing something out there every day. Some of it's dangerous and some more dangerous than others. And so anyway, it was several months later and then somebody told me that I had been recommended for the medal. And I just thought, well, if we get it, maybe I'll get to go back to Washington, you know, and see the president. But it finally did come out and we were to go to Melbourne, Australia, which we did, we flew down there. The presentation of the medal, and all my crew received the Silver Star, and I received the Medal of Honor, and we flew back the next day, 700 miles back to where we were, so I thought at least maybe they'd get a little relaxation there, you know, but we didn't even get that.